type of composition. It did not work well for them. Let's see if they can pick up the pieces today and try to take out Origin. First ban off the board is going to be that Graves.
So, Graves not available. We've seen a bit of a rise of prominence of Graves the last couple of days. Again, just saw it in the previous game for Splice, but they did get perfect game, so can't draw too many conclusions on that.
Excluding the Elise, it was also Spirit's most played jungler. I want to see if whether or not they're going to ban Lee Sin, which is something that Spirit has fallen back to multiple times when it has been available.
Zendan coming in, and the Kalista follows suit. So, no Kalistar, not in any way, shape, or form.
That's a curious one, Pyra. So Forbidden used to be known for his Zed, very much so. And is kind of a pick that is hovering around the meta, but it's certainly not a top tier mid laner. We've seen a lot of Azir the last couple of days. We know Peke hasn't been too hot on the Azir over time.
Yeah, and of course, earlier today in LCK, Faker actually lost in with his Zed. I wonder if it's not being set up for a potential LeBlanc pick. With the Zed gone away, the Azir gone away, the support from the jungler of Graves, maybe looking for a comfortable pick. You could just go safe and lock in Corki if you wanted to.
Yeah, but Nidalee was left open with the Lulu band away. That's instantly snapped up by Origin. Amazing will be happy to get his claws on that one.
And there is a lot available for Gamsu. They have not taken anything really away from Gamsu's playbook. You could argue the Graves has been top lane as well. So, I mean, now the Poppy's up for Gamsu, the Nautilus, although we have seen no Nautilus yet this week. Small hit to his kit with the patch 6.5, but nobody's wanted to play it.
Yesterday, Poppy Lucian was the picks for Fnatic. They were red side against Elements, and we've seen a major priority on Poppy this week with that hit that Nautilus has taken, so I'd expect that one not to change.
Yeah, I would expect the same with the Poppy, but the Lucian is an interesting one to me. And as Corki gets locked in, remember yesterday Origin showed us that they can play Jhin. And the interesting thing about that is Fnatic actually ban away the Kalista now. At IEM, this was a play they hardly ever did because they'd allow their opponents to take the Kalista and they'd reply with the Jhin. So obviously not getting baited into this by Origin. They know both sides of the coin are playable by both teams.
Oh yeah, and there is a reason these two were at the top of the table last year. It's still a hype matchup between them. There's that Trundle being considered, but I also want to think about this, Jhin. It's still an option. We've seen Febiven just go absolutely ham on Corki. It's still available.
It is still available, but as kind of expected for Origin, if ever they can get Sven onto the Lucian, always has been a good pick for him. He's very strong at pretty much every point of the game for Sven. Haven't got the Lulu to pair it with, but I wouldn't be too worried about that if I were an Origin fan.
And Captain Sirius, there's your Trundle. does land in Soez's hands. Look, there is the possibility that it could be flexed for Miffy to run. He has done it twice this split already, but we're anticipating it to end up in Soez's hands. And for Fnatic, they've now got to reveal whether or not they want to run that Corki ADC or just give it to Febiven as a comfort pick. He had a great performance last week, despite looking average and slow at IEM.
Yeah, at this point though, I'm wondering now where the mid lane and top lane, or not top lane, sorry, the mid lane is going to go for Origin, because Nidalee is fairly reliant on having winning lanes that you can go in and counter jungle. That's one of the biggest things right now for Nidalee, and if they can't push in mid lane and bottom lane, I mean, top lane Trundle is not really going to push too hard early on, especially not in this kind of matchup. Trundle is going to be a later game pick here. So Amazing may not have the same kind of freedom that we've grown accustomed to a Nidalee having in the early game.
Yeah, that is definitely true. But if Origin can get off to a flying start, we'll see what they end up rounding their bottom lane out with. The Braum was, of course, taken away, but you got to consider the supports that are still available. And well, the Bard wasn't one of the first that came to mind, but if they do pick that up, that would be something.
Yeah, it would be. And I wouldn't be surprised to see this LeBlanc locked in. Get away, get rid of one of those natural counters in Zed. It does allow Febiven to play a strong early game mid laning in that Corki if he opts into it. But basically going to reveal their hand and allow Fnatic to decide. What do they want to run? A counter to the LeBlanc, or a comfort pick that can stall later? Or just lock in the Jhin or a different ADC for Reckless and play that poke siege style that they can.
That is the question.
Work around the prom.
Well, out. That's a Bard locked in with a LeBlanc, so we will see.
So going from EU LCS alone, this is the first time we'll be seeing Miffy on the Bard. And, you know, it's kind of so far removed from his preferential champions. He likes the Alistar, the Braum, the Trundle, those kind of tanky champions. Bard doesn't really get that. He's a lot more about that catch and lockdown and that kind of utility rather than just tank. And, you know, what he will offer with the Lucian is insane amounts of damage in the laning phase. You can look at Bard and Lucian right now and say, well, Sven and Miffy, they want to dominate the 2v2 here. If they end up in that situation, Then, how do Fnatic respond to that? Do they now look for a different AD carry that can play a little bit further back, or do they look for something with lane presence on itself? I don't know whether you can really, you know, have more damage in trades than Lucian and Bard right now with this setup.
Well, one man might know the answer. We just saw Daylor on the screen, and as we say it, the Ezreal's locked in for Reckless. This has been something he's gone to pre-IEM, of course, and pre-Jhin.
Well, if you're a Fnatic fan and you follow their EU LCS record, Reckless is 0-3 on Ezreal. He has to turn that around if Fnatic want to pick up a win here, even out that head-to-head score, set themselves up for some very strong tiebreaker possibilities. But Poke, Siege, that's what it's all the name of the game for Fnatic.
That's not the only unfortunate set of stats for you. Gamsu is also 0-3 on Poppy right now. So as good as a pick it is in the meta and should seemingly fit, Gamsu hasn't really been one of those picks for them that they've been big on.
Yeah, it has been a lot of trouble for him. Gamsu himself has had quite a lot of ups and downs in the performances, and we'll have to see if Origin can get it.
I'm a big fan of what Origin have put together in terms of their pick power and priorities. The flags are lit on stage, Fnatic and Origin, the two heavyweights of a European LCS in 2015. Now battling for fourth seed, how the mighty have fallen. Ladies and gentlemen, jump onto Twitter and let us know who you think is going to be picking up these wins. You know the deal. Hashtag OGWin or hashtag FNCWin, because it's all about this. There we go. There's your team comps, everybody. That's what I've been looking for. You know the story. You know the comps. It's time to load up for Fnatic versus Origin. Is going to finish this one off.
Golden Pace, he got it!
Oh, it's always a great one between these two teams. Fnatic Origin, a good old classic here in Europe. Only a year in the making. Let's see how it goes as they get ready to go. Onto the Rift.
Onto the Rift, and I'm going to immediately draw your attention to the items pane, because if ever there was an indicator that OG want to look to take this game at the beginning, the crowd are hyped. It's a Dark Seal start on LeBlanc. Going for that Medjize, they want to snowball hard from mid.
Oh, no hiding about it. Xpeke says, we can beat you guys. We are that much better. It'll be a tough, tough task, even though Fnatic had been struggling a bit. They showed they have the potential to really rock some faces after IEM. Gotta be careful, Peke. Early dash away.
And remember, both of these teams have completely different mindsets after yesterday's performances. Fnatic dropping the game to Elements was a monumental shock for European LCS viewers. And Origin absolutely crushed Giants in the most dominant performance they've had all split long. So now we need to see how they're gonna react to the stage, to the pressure, knowing how important seeding is.
Yeah, well, the crowd not only behind teams apparently right now, Trevor. You've got
hey, that's a first. That's a first. I'll take that one.
We've got a whole new one going here. It's a new tradition, new day in Europe. But yeah, the seeding is just such an all-important thing, because the difference between fourth and sixth can mean quite a lot. And of course, a whole lot of tiebreakers in the event of Fnatic winning.
Yeah, it can mean a lot, but everybody's focus right now is going to be on this all-important game, because, I mean, right now, you look at what Origin have got set up, the Thunderlords as standard on Braum, you want that trading damage, works so well with the Meeps as well, but what they're looking at here is Peke against Febiven in this middle lane, and, you know, LeBlanc into Corki, it tends to be a matchup where Corki will shove out fairly heavily early on. You've got to use Distortion to try and push that wave back, and that leaves you in a bit of trouble every now and again.
It does, as Gamsu is right now. Origin initiated the lane swap. We'll see how this pans out in terms of who's going to get the tower pressure down, but maybe a double psych. Fnatic not opting into it despite the power of that Lucian Bard. You know, trying to run away from it, and Origin outthinking themselves, maybe.
The other side from this is it does give Origin a little bit more room when it comes to this nidly middle lane, though Soaz already in.
Oh, has to spend the exhaust and the flash to get away from Soaz. A lot of damage return fire onto him, but he is looking low and bleeding to start this game off.
And this now really punishes Febiven, because there's no way he can reliably continue to push out, because just the LeBlanc, now that exhaust is gone, is going to be able to burst Febiven down. Ignite on LeBlanc, so all she's got to do is trade once or twice in the lane, and then go in for the all-in, and Febiven has to play this carefully now for the next few minutes.
Yeah, you said it yourself, looking to snowball. He's got that Dark Seal. If he can start picking the kills on it, it could be a sure way to a monster LeBlanc in that mid game. We see the clinical swap in the top, in the bottom, just 3-0 to start things off. A little bit of gold infused into both these teams, and no other aggression but the mid.
And something that we've noticed more and more as these lane swaps progress out is how teams work with the Rift Herald in those next stages 4, stages 5. And both Fnatic and Origin had pretty good performances with the Rift Herald at Intel Extreme Masters. So I want to take a look at who's going to get the priority, who's going to be able to secure the buff, and then more importantly, apply pressure on the turrets to gain any sort of lead. So Soaz will share that gold with Sven, as his recall didn't finish just in time. And Sven's already picked up that cull, as we're seeing more and more Tia and Cull, something we're also seeing from Ezreal's across the world.
Yep, across the world, fairly standard right now. We spoke to Forgiven yesterday to ask why he seems to be the only AD carry that doesn't build it. And he was just like, eh, you know, I don't think he gives you too much. So it definitely is player preference. And you can see how this middle lane has flipped now. It's Peke that's shoving in Forbiven. Forbiven is kind of just going to sit back for a while, knows he has to just play somewhat safe. And honestly, that is the big turnaround there for Origin, is they managed to now really put Febavan under pressure just from Soaz coming mid early. It was a little bit different of a timed gank in that middle lane. You don't always expect that to happen, and it's allowed Soaz to not only help his middle laner, but now that he gets top, this is a little late to back away, but as long as Klai doesn't get a Q here, Soaz should be fine.
So Soaz is pushing that wave out as best he can, trying to prevent any sort of shenanigans that Fnatic can put down, and very good trade. In actual fact, Peke opted into that and comes off worse for wear. Support from Mithy roaming up. Can the Cosmic Binding stun? There's a wall. Finds Febavent, but there's no follow-up from Peke.
It was already under tower, so Mithy tries to help Peke make the play. Not quite enough. Spirit, however, is going to be going through his own jungle, see if he can get some defense down to this bottom side. A big wave was pushing in towards it, thanks to Sven, as they turned this one around. So after the early tower trades, not a whole lot doing, but OG do have a 500 gold lead.
Yeah, look at the difference in approach. No pressure from Rekkles and Klein in that top lane. They've opted to freeze, give all that farm to Gumsu. And that's going to help out in this Poppy Trundle matchup, because Soaz is going to have to either overextend, which you can see him doing on the minimap right now, very little vision, but there is support with Mithy and Amazing coming up the river.
Yeah, and this is going to be the key thing here, is the vision that comes from Mithy and Amazing not only will help protect Soaz, but if you see Amazing and Peke go around as a two-man roam squad here, they could look for Febavan in the middle lane right now. If they wanted to swoop down from the backside, it looks like they want to focus topside right now, but there are kind of pockets opening. They got a flash from Gamsu as well.
Yeah, burned him away here. Peke still trading a little bit with Febavan in the mid, but a lot of pressure on OG's side. Now Sven is moving on, and Febavan didn't see that one coming. A dash and a dash back. The Valkyrie not quite getting him out of harm's way. He's oh so low, but under tower.
Well, listen, you bring Peke in to the mid lane, and he just says, everyone come help. We've seen everybody but Amazing in that middle lane. And talking about things we're seeing, Fnatic want to see a whole lot. 5 pink wards in their inventory.
Well, right now, against the likes of a Nidalee, a Bard that's going to look to get in the enemy jungle, a LeBlanc that you want to try and catch out, you have to have that vision. But a little bit of a different page there from Peke and Sven. They obviously had no real crowd control without the chains landing, and Peke didn't want to commit. There was a lot of minions pushing towards him. He wanted the farm. So it's another situation where Febavan gets pushed back away, and it's hindering his lane now. Peke is up by just over 10 CS, and this is a good start for Origin.
Yeah, and it's all that pressure and all the attention they've been giving this mid lane to keep Febavan on his toes, recognizing his superior threat, recognizing that they need to shut him down before he gets going. It's so different from last year's Origin, where Peke pretty much AFK'd for 30 minutes before his team would usually win the game.
Yeah, that is fairly true, but the one thing that they have sacrificed for this is Soaz. He is down in CS, is about a level behind as well. I think he's about to hit level 5, and Gamsu has been 5 for a while. Yeah, there is the level up for Soaz. So that's what they've been kind of hamstringing to get this attention onto Peke, which, if they can start getting kills from mid lane, should be okay for Origin, but this Trundle is going to be so necessary the later this game goes to be able to hold against Gamsu.
We'll see how well both teams play out the mid game. Rekkles and Klein are moving their way up top.
And there's our best friend.
As Soaz catches that wave down bottom. So this is the longest time that he's going to be sitting comfortably farming. And Fnatic have invested some of those resources into vision in terms of that bottom quadrant. Spirit, after losing his red buff, we caught a glimpse of Amazing securing that one, will most likely be able to come up top. 1, 2, 3, 4 members of Fnatic theoretically setting up a siege.
Up on the top side, we'll take a look. And that is not the fan vote we expect when we hear all those Fnatic chants week in and week out. It appears they've been eclipsed this time by Origin.
The power of expect here, Pyra.
Yeah, and the power of not wanting tiebreakers, apparently. Four members, though, up on this top side. Spirit stunned by the Cosmic Binding. Ooh, just gets away safe.
Teleport coming out, though. Here comes Soaz.
Let's find out what he can do. Keeper's Verdict boots Sven away. That's one of the primary damage dealers. But the Pillar of Ice splits up Fnatic. Four members slow. Mystic Shot goes wide from Reckless as Klai is forced to flash away defensively. Pounces forward for Amazing. Reckless and Gumsu trying to get away from the lives. But here comes Feathervent.
Big package on in there. And Exhaust is down instantaneously, stunned up. Origin looking for a second win. Everyone's getting bloodied, and the first blood goes to Amazing.
That's the only kill, though, of this entire fight here. One kill for the entire trade. Now Gamsu's going to collect the wave from bottom lane. At this point, Peke decided very early on in that fight, I'm not going to go for the damage dealers. I'm going to go for the level 3 Braum here. Force the flash, get damage onto a couple of other people. And it got Fnatic so low that they couldn't reliably stand behind Klai at any point. A lot of summoners burned from both teams during that engagement. Febben kind of showing up just enough to make Origin back off at the end of that fight, and when it's all said and done, it's one kill from all of that fighting.
Yeah, and of course, all started off with Fnatic pushing this gigantic wave into the tower. Gamsu is already with the team. Great flash. I had missed that flash the first time around, but I really like the fact that Origin with no hesitation on the call to engage.
Well, the Poppy L, even though Amazing flashed it, it was Lucian that got blasted back, so I was kind of holding whether it was a good flash or not at the beginning. Peke managed to roam up first before Febben, even with the package. But that was such a good double binding out by Mithy. I said maybe Mithy isn't the biggest Bard player when it comes to his performances here in the European LCS. Great stun, locks two people down, allows for the kill.
Yeah, and with the way Fnatic were pretty much pinned up against the wall in the start of that fight, you almost have to question Febben's decision to go in on the package Valk, because he just ends up losing his life on that one.
Oh, this is scary. This is scary. Hello.
Reckless.
Oh, woohoo. I don't know why I'm so excited, because there's support coming for Fnatic. Spirits and Klai come down, but they get Reckless's flash. And Origin, they're now grouped for this tower.
Why do you always bring so many members to this party?
They do. They've got a magical journey to get there. It was a little bit optimistic by Mithy. I think he was like, everybody go! And then they realized they've got no minion wave behind it. So it was a good journey not to take.
Hey, they got the summoner spell.
Yeah, so. They did. It's still a good trade onto Reckless. But Gamsu is extending this lead. Look at it. 75 CS to 46 right now. Gamsu level 8 to Soaz level 6. And we were talking about how if you can take Gamsu away from Fnatic, take him off his strengths, that's when Fnatic look weakest. And right now, Gamsu's getting a lot of room to breathe.
Yeah, it really is. A lot of resources. Currently around 700 gold more than his opponent, Soaz. But we need to see it work. 50% of that cooldown for Teleport is available. Very good combo from Peke onto Febben. Wins that trade out, and it looks like this bottom tower will fall the second of the game in favor of Origin. So they extend their gold lead to just shy of 2,000 as the game progresses.
Yep, unanswered there by Fnatic. Pressure is too real on him. Febben still on his toes as Peke just keeps leaping in, leaping out. Soaz now looking onto the free farm for a while. He has been down versus Gamsu, but he will have a bit of a chance to try and answer a little bit of it back. Origin, however, they're bringing more people into this mid. Amazing still there. The wave is gone from Febben's Foss Bomb. Now they continue on their journey up to the top.
The thing is, they can't commit for that tower at any point yet. It's still basically full health. Ah, Mithy gets his recall stop and gets a ward. So just enough to protect Peke. Everything from this game is like, well, let's get Peke fed, and hopefully this will win the game for us.
I think that's super important when you consider Corki and Ezreal, the two champions of Fnatic, are running from their mid and ADC. If Peke is able to chunk them out or burst them down out of team fights, that just gives so much freedom to Origin. Especially when you consider how limited their wave clear is.
Yeah, the problem though is if they're stacking so much towards that, then if they get caught in a fight where Peke is not there, if, for instance, Spirit, Febben can find, Soaz as he's underleveled, or even Sven, somebody like that.
That's one way to clear a wave.
It's gonna be difficult one. I just think of those minions as, if I take one more step from here, this is the furthest I've ever been.
At least they're all together.
That is a part of the rift that a Siege minion has never seen. Got a one-way ticket
out of water
to the danger zone just in front of the Brambleback.
All right. So the Rift Herald gets taken by Amazing after all of that loveliness, and they still are stacking very heavily on this top side. Klai might be caught in a trap here. Magical Journey Flash.
It's not over yet because now Gamsu's coming in. There's no Keeper's Verdict because he used it on the minions. Klai's gone down. Now Gamsu's got four members to deal with. Amazing's killed out. One more auto. Teleport from Soaz into the waiting hands of Spirit. The Flash kick back.
Meanwhile, Febivin, though, he's caught up with the chains, but not enough damage Pekka could put down to take him out. It's just a one for one, Klein, Amazing, both going down.
It was enough, though, to show that Pekka was coming up from the bottom side with the Ignite. It meant that after the Bard ultimate, everybody from Fnatic was like, okay, I don't think we can take this fight. And again, Mithy is showing us that he is pretty proficient on Bard right now. He's landed some big abilities.
Yeah, let's take a look at it here. Klein, you know, he gets away for the moment, but still, a lot could have been avoided if Gamsu had only held that ult.
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, Gamsu right now knows he can get the damage down onto Amazing. Reckless will be calling this now. The fact that the Braum Q hit, or at least the passive proc before Braum died, was such a big factor there because it meant they had to keep moving back. But Reckless just on the edge of that tempered fate. But here was Pekka zoning from the bottom side. Febberman has to be careful in all of these situations.
And I think it's very important that Gamsu, as a player who was at, really far ahead of Soaz, now has a teleport and flash advantage over Soaz. So I want to see if Fnatic can play the side lanes. They're still 2,000 gold down, so they have to play intelligently around the map to claw back that gold deficit.
The thing is, Soaz over the last few minutes has recouped so much of that deficit. I mean, we were at 75 to 40 at one point with CS and a two-level advantage. That has been evened out to now just about a third of a level between Gamsu and Soaz. So there's been a lot of extra time for Soaz to get himself back into the game. But one player that's had to put themselves a little bit behind the curve on their build is Febivin here. He went Hex Drinker before the Triforce is completed.
I know you love that.
Well, we've heard a lot of mid laners talking about this. So it's not ideal, but against somebody like a LeBlanc that already has presence over you and is looking to snowball this game out, it's pretty necessary right now. You have to stay alive. You cannot afford to give kills over to the LeBlanc.
This is all part of Origin's plan, forcing Febivin into a more defensive posture and a more defensive build, slowing him down. Not only that, they gave Soaz a lot of that farm. They said, no, you need to eat. You're starving. Come down here. Go up there and take it away, and then we'll give you some attention. So they're not leaving him out to dry, and that is a very important thing as Mithy looks to chase in on the Gamsu here. Tempered Fate is flashed.
All right, Mithy playing very aggressive on that front line. He's going to take the fight to the teleport lane of Gamsu, knowing that he's got that summoner ability. Pekka playing super confident on the side lane, pushing the wave up as Soaz goes to catch the wave up top. So Origin in a controlling position. Quite say commanding yet. Oh. Fnatic have to figure out how to respond because look, they're dealing with pressure in two lanes at once.
Yeah, spears are starting to hurt. Nidalee pressure from Amazing. He'll have some late game scaling too going for the Rod of Ages. Slower, but he's able to get it and Pekka just keeps on pressuring.
Soaz has showed top though, and with no teleport, that does allow Fnatic at least the knowledge to know that Origin aren't about to start a fight anytime soon, especially with the Bard ultimate down. You can't make picks, you can't really look to do too much more than just push out lanes like this.
Well, Origin seem to do that very effectively. Remember that Origin and Fnatic are fighting for the fourth seed through sixth, with the Unicorns of Love as a third member in that race. Good damage onto Spirit, even without a full combo from Pekka.
Yeah. Unicorn's definitely still in that horse race, but Origin, they can lock it up here with a win without forcing any tiebreakers with the way things are shaking out right now. They do have that lead. Can they keep it? That's the question. Fnatic, they have beaten the odds several times in their long and storied history as an organization. See if they can do it yet again.
This might be one of the best early games we have seen from Origin. The trend is continuing. The shot calling, the map play, the proactive moments. From when Pekka was playing last week, even with PoE yesterday against, you know, a struggling Giant squad, against Fnatic, Origin, they've taken hold of the lead and they've pressured Fnatic continuously over the last 17 minutes.
And that is just so important going towards the playoffs. We've heard so much from the players of Origin themselves saying that Pekka is the presence that they actually need. But as you said, even with PoE, they were still able to do just that. It's almost like the shot calling was in there all along. They just had to bring it out.
Oh, man. I'm having so many flashbacks to like Transformers the movie, the animated one. Anyway, as we look back perhaps at the 17 minutes so far in this game, Spirit as of yet, hasn't had too much of an opportunity to do anything on the map. And a lot of that is because of how Febavin's been on the back foot. Just the fact that Amazing has been given entry into Spirit's jungle a few times has meant that Spirit hasn't been looking to skirmish, hasn't been looking for plays too often. And he's been there on the fights, but all he's been doing is disengaging. Really, he's not been looking for kills. And when we saw Fnatic doing well with the Lee Sin, a lot of it came from Spirit's performances here on Lee Sin. You know, going side by side with Febavin, with Gamsu, and actually picking people off.
Yeah, and of course, the inability to find targets as easily in the lane swap, where he got the more opportunity to do that in previous Lee Sin performances, might be a big reason. Gamsu's already picked up the QSS. So, second item, after he's grabbed the Sunfire Cape, going to be very useful against some of the hard CC that is on the side of Origin. And Origin now extending the deep vision, pushing into Fnatic's jungle.
It's interesting, though, because we were speaking to Steve yesterday on the analyst desk, and he was saying that, you know, when it comes to building QSS against Trundle to just get rid of Subjugate, he actually doesn't really think that's cost efficient, because you've put so much gold into just one active that just removes the Subjugate, and that's it. You don't get trading stats past that. I mean, there is argument to be made that Trundle is at his strongest when that's available for him and is you know, working. So I don't think it's a particularly bad thing, but what it does allow Soaz is to know, I'm going to stop saying bad English. What Soaz will know here is he can trade more effectively overall against Gamsu, not just when his ult's up.
Yeah, and that's pretty critical. The issue for Gamsu here is, on top of it, what else is he going to get? A little bit of MR to deal with Pekka and Amazing, sure. But what does he then turn that into? The Mercurial Scimitar, right? Or, like, what is he going
to
do?
Yeah, we'll have to answer that question later. Gamsu's in trouble. Steadfast Presence is up.
Bold.
There is some support from Spirit as the Verdict sends Amazing away. And Gamsu gets away just using an ultimate.
Yeah, but look at the numbers that Fnatic had here. Keeper's Verdict was used, and it was really only Soaz that was there. I wonder, Fnatic, could they have looked to have done something more there? They didn't have the most amount of vision through the entrances to their jungle, so I guess they just didn't have a complete read on where Origin were.
I mean, Fnatic are playing the stall game now.
Yeah.
Trinity Force was just picked up for Febavin. The Mirror Man has been completed for Reckless for a little while, but he hasn't got a second item completed. We know Ezreal really only becomes super powered once he's got that Frozen Fist and maybe Blade of the Rune King as well. So, you know, Fnatic have got a lot of headroom to grow with this Corki and Ezreal combination. And once they get some MR under their belt, the threat of a LeBlanc becomes lowered, is the word I'm going to use. Not insignificant, but it is still a long time away. So Origin are in this great power spike moment or time with their team composition, and I want to see how they pressure use it.
Yeah, critically, they have to be able to press it on forward. If they don't, they start running into trouble because you get into this late game situation where you have LeBlanc, Nidalee, and Lucian who aren't particularly going to hit much harder in those later stages. And Fnatic, they're going to hope to outlast, outlive, and be able to outfight.
Well, you always got to keep in mind Sven on Lucian seems to find the right angles, right areas.
That's true.
To get the damage down. But you do bring up a pretty good point, though, is with the Ezreal, with the likes of the Corki, it is going to be Fnatic. They may have an opportunity to come back into this game as well here. That's only the second dragon of the game going down here, as we're cresting 20 minutes, 21 minutes. So, you know, this could be in for a bit of a long one here. And Origin's early game comp may start running out of juice.
Well, Dark Seal on one stack.
Worst investment.
Not the most kill focused game, but there has been a lot of action. You can see Gamsu's in trouble.
Yeah, Pekka wants to get one. He flashes away, and there he's going to start adding some stacks on. Pekka picking up his first kill of the game.
Made it look easy.
Yeah.
He did. Well, I mean, there's no way that hammer was going to hit him. Gamsu, he was bluffing.
Yeah, against a LeBlanc is basically like going into a hall of mirrors with a hammer. Just you got to try and swing it everywhere. Unfortunately, Keeper's Verdict doesn't work like that. It goes in one place.
Yeah, but the mirrors aren't going to kill you.
Well, if you swing the hammer hard enough, they might.
Exactly.
Let's see it again. Like, Pekka just says, no, this is mine.
Sorry, I'm still thinking about my hall of mirrors. But anyway, at this point, boop, Pekka still got it.
I like how he flashed just so he could then distort.
And I really think that pick ban phase, getting rid of that Azir, come for pick for Febavin, getting rid of Zed, come for pick, historic pick for Febavin. Made it even easier, even more comfortable for Pekka. Added to the fact that everybody and their dog came to pay a visit to mid lane and really just, you know, usher Pekka into the mid game, but now he's taking control, playing those side lanes, found a pick solo, and is a real, real threat. 6,000 gold Origin have built up more than Fnatic.
Yeah, and that has really exploded the last couple of minutes. They picked up a whole bunch of things across the map. Three turrets up, 4-1. And right now, honestly, for Origin, this is one of the better games that we've seen from them, but part of me is thinking that it's just because Fnatic are sitting back. In so much of this, Fnatic aren't really looking to make plays themselves. They're not looking for objectives. They're not even looking to fight. And that's because Fnatic are buying time for Reckless to get himself into this game, for Febben to get a couple of items and really just weather the storm that has been Peke trying to kill him again and again.
Yeah, and as a result, Origin said, that's just fine. If you're not going to fight us, if you're not going to contest for your objectives, we won't snowball on kills, we'll snowball on objectives. 4 towers to 1 is that score, and that makes up a pretty big chunk of what that gold differential is. And the fact that they've kind of adopted a no man left behind, gotten Soaz back up to CS, he's actually built a lead now over Gamsu, who's had a hell of a time trying to get back into this one. And Fnatic have actually sent a lot of members up to this top side to finally knock down that outer turret.
Hey, it didn't go so well for them the last time they tried Pyrus. So Fnatic may be back away going, hang on, we don't quite have the vision and the fact that Peke is shoving in this bottom lane.
Oh, TP's coming bottom lane. Gamsu, though, into the jungle.
Let's find out who's in trouble. Sven's been pinned against the wall. The True Shot barrage comes down, and Sven's running for his life.
Yeah, the True Shot didn't even hit him as he was popped up in the air for just a moment. So missed timing by Fnatic. They've got to back out.
Big missed timing. Gamsu utilized his teleport there. Bit of a rough time from Reckless, obviously trying to calculate the velocity of Banana. I don't know how fast they really travel. But
well, Klai didn't know that either, so
clearly
they've got trouble with that fruit. Klai himself is in a lot of trouble. That looks not so unbreakable. He's got to have to burn his flash to get away. This opens the gates right now for Fnatic to try for the inner, but it's Soaz who puts the pillar down, and Klai says, stand behind me. I'll stand behind Reckless, but he's standing at the fountain after that, and a quick kill picked up. Peke getting the assist on that one. Spirit gets the pick off to Sven, and he's down. Reckless with a pickup to answer it back. And Mithy now going low from the rockets. Magical Journey is taken. Soaz is trying to get out of there. That was a short one. See if he can get himself to safety. Fnatic still trying for the chase. They back away now.
He's going to be out. And Peke wants to go back in, but thought second of it as 4 people were standing around him. So that initially it was a play that Fnatic had to make. They looked to be heading top to take down top turret, but noticed Sven sitting in the middle lane and didn't want to lose their mid tower from this. So this is after Fnatic initiated the play. They looked to lock down Klai. This is a good set of damage onto it, but then Origin looked to commit. Soaz says, okay, I can come from the top side. This is good for us. The problem is right here. Fnatic now enclose Origin and put a lot of damage down from afar by Febben and Reckless here. It's all on Spirit, kicking Sven right into the waiting arms of Reckless and Gamsu. And from there, Origin does have to retreat out. Even though Soaz is fairly strong right now, he cannot afford to be there.
And multiple flashes blown to get away from that Dragon's Rage kick. There's trouble here for Febben. The chains come down. Exhaust is on Peke, but it's just buying time. Oh, that was a little close, but eventually Febben goes down. Ended up using that exhaust for a few seconds. Look at the bottom lane. Gamsu's being pushed in deep as Soaz has used his subjugate. QSS comes out, and Gamsu unable to fend off Soaz.
5 towers to 1 after all said and done. Peke gets himself another kill. He's starting to stack him up. He's got 6 sitting on that Dark Seal. Now he's saying that's a worthwhile investment. Just took some time to pay out.
Yeah, that's stacking up. Got to get that Dark Seal going.
And of course, that's the damage from the team fight that we caught on replay a moment or two ago that led into the Raptor camp, with Reckless doing a whole lot, but he was standing on the back line by that True Shot barrage, those Mystic Shots, etc.
He was poking away from the back where Sven was dead before it really got going.
Yeah, he was a little preoccupied.
So, he didn't get too much damage out there. Also, you had the same feeling I did with that True Shot barrage. I was like, ooh, halfway across the map. Turns out it's on his own team.
Yeah.
That happens.
I was hoping it was going to buy time for Febben to flash, but it didn't work out, unfortunately. And Febben then got dropped. And with an 8,000 gold deficit, it's a good time to remind everybody what's at stake. If Origin win this game, we have a maximum possible number of tiebreakers of 2 games. Origin win.
And Origin would guarantee themselves a 4th place finish, which would, of course, then put Fnatic in 6th, and that locks Unicorns into that 5th place spot. So the picture starts to get a little more clear. Fnatic win? Still foggy.
Up to 6 games, Pyra. That
yeah,
is
that's
what
a lot.
The forecast is.
Hey, we love ties here in EU.
For a turn in the weather.
We'd love to break them even more.
But that weather would have to be a drastic typhoon change for Fnatic to claw back the 7,000 gold deficit. But, you know, we've talked history. Last year, Fnatic did it. In their 18-0 run in the regular season, they punished OG, who had a 5K gold lead at the time, or a 6K. but this is worlds apart and different scenarios entirely. Look at that damage.
Yay, Pekke. They're really, we're right in putting it on him there. Still not enough to zero someone out, but I mean, he's just a constant threat, and Fnatic have to respect it.
You mentioned last year, though, this is, as you said, worlds apart from where we are now for these two teams. Fnatic just seem to have the same kind of problems. It seems like if Gamsu isn't 100% comfortable and is able to get in every kind of fight or push, just kind of needlessly in side lanes, if they can't get that working for them, it becomes impossible for Fnatic to actually win. Teleport's going to be used by Gamsu here, so they've already got the summoner spell, so that's already worth it for Origin.
Yeah, no harm whatsoever. Soas, he had actually spent his teleport as well, so that just about evens out. But 28 minutes is the timer on the clock. Fnatic are trying to make something happen in this mid. Remember, they only have one tower on the map. This should be them taking one down, but can Origin counter-engage this one? Pekke is nowhere to be found. Tempered Fate lands on three, I should say.
Spirit's in trouble. He's not going to be able to get away. Flash was unavailable. He didn't even get the kick down. The Glacial Fissure gets put down by Klai to disengage the fight, but Pekke is looking for blood. He's going to dance around the flank, and Miffy saves the tower.
But it's all better for Origin because they just peel back up towards the Baron. Fnatic know they have to at least move that way and just protect against a potential Baron start here. Spirit still dead for 25 seconds, allows Origin a little bit of room.
It does a little, but Origin, they're going for the Baron. Four members of Fnatic are still alive.
Pekke, though.
And Gamsu is around. Pekke is playing on the flank. Pillar of Ice comes down to buy some time. Klai does not have his ultimate. Febby was stuck against the wall, but the engage breaks out.
Gamsu goes in, he's exhausted immediately, and suddenly Pekke around the side. He's exhausted right back, but Gamsu's the one who goes down. Sven will pew-pew him out of this one. Reckless trying to kite out, but Pekke is hunting. He's going. Chains are on. He takes him out for Reckless. That was too much for a fast for him. Febivin now going low, stopped by the pillar, taken down. It's only Klai. Spirits come back up trying to join the fight, but Origin have already ended it.
The Baron was not secured. It doesn't look done yet. Soez decides to go forward. Sonic Wave from Spirit finds nobody. A 1-for-3 extended trade, and Origin will take themselves an inner turret and maybe more.
Yeah, there's a big wave. The Spirit just went to absorb in the top side. Origin are going to look to push this through. 30 seconds left on most of their damage here. Reckless up in just under 20 means Origin will be able to secure themselves an inhibitor. And we haven't seen this style of play from Origin in a good long while. They're playing with multiple threats and feel very confident doing it. Pekke's a threat, Sven's a threat, and even Soaz is. This is a better Origin than we've seen in quite some time.
They've got their mojo back. That cannot be questioned. This Baron play was bold, and it netted some serious results. Gamsu goes in. Well, you know the rest. All of a sudden, he's low.
Yeah, a little bit of mistiming here from Origin when it came to when Pekke was coming into the fight. He knew he had to burn the exhaust, though. He knew he wasn't going to get the instant damage down, and couldn't quite get the damage on Pekke before Pekke returned it. The auto attack follows him over the wall, but the ignite was what finished that one off. From here, it's easy pickings for Origin as they manage to drop the next two. But again, Origin are playing a lot more confident than we've seen them. Maybe this is the effect that Pekke has on the lineup that Amazing even talked about, is he brings just this level of safety for Origin. They feel just a little bit more together while playing.
And what a mind threat this is going to be for teams looking at the playoffs. You know, coming into the split, there was always going to be the talk that Pekke and Power of Evil were going to swap. They were going to have two active mid laners. At least that's what the public-facing news was. And it didn't happen until Power of Evil was actually a little too ill to play on stage. And now they've brought Pekke in. Yes, Fnatic are a team who are also struggling at the moment. They dropped the game to Elements, which is something that nobody was expecting yesterday. So you have to take that into account. But you also now have to measure the threat and the risk of pulling the Pekke card as quarterfinals are looming ever closer.
It's just something that Origin have been packing in the back pocket. And they finally bring it out once again, and you can see the results. 10,000 gold in the lead, and this Baron threat is just so constant. Inhibitors down in the middle. Fnatic are having to respect this. It's already halfway down.
Right now, only one blue trinket was available for Fnatic. They will get the vision.
There is the threat for a steal. Tempered Fate comes out, but it's actually picked up by Pekke. Spirit dived in to try steal and gives up his life for the trade. True Shot Barrage has already been fired, and Gamsu, he can't find Soaz with the verdict. Baron secured. The power play is on.
Spirit tried himself a good old steal, but was denied. Crisp play from Origin across the board. Let's see where they can pressure next. There's a big wave down on the bottom side. Soez and Sven have come to intercept and push it in with Baron and Power of Minions. Fnatic, they're hanging on for dear life in their own base.
And realistically, if you'd have told me coming into 2016 that Febiven would have been pushed around by Xpeke, who wasn't even the starter on the lineup for Origin, I would have called you a liar, people, after how Worlds Febiven played. But we find ourselves in one of the last games of the split, and that is exactly what has happened. Febiven just has not been able to get into this game at all.
No, he hasn't, and Origin are looking to end the game. Super Minions are on the steps of Fnatic's base, and the inhibitor is under siege. Soez has thrown down the Subjugate. He's playing the frontline tank he needs to be. Glacial Fish is trying to separate it as a bootback throws Soez. He's dropped. Inhibitor shield falls shortly, and Sven gets the final autos down. One for Inhib. Good trade for OG.
They've got to call Worth on that one, and it took them so long to take down Soez. You could see he was tanking up the entire team of Fnatic, blowing all their cooldowns on him. So now, two inhibitors down. Still the Baron power play intact. And now, Origin can look to make the end game. If they can move up topside, keep the pressure constant on mid, this is going to be oh so tough for Fnatic to hang on.
Well, Soez dying does slow him down, though. That is the removal of the Baron buff on the side lane split pusher that they were looking for. So there was only about a minute left now with when you take into account the death time on Soez that Baron would have been available, but certainly a little over-aggressive. They have got two inhibitors and are in a very comfortable situation. It's a 12,000 gold lead right now for Origin. So realistically, there aren't too many ways of Fnatic getting into this game, save from Origin making a horrendous mistake. Honestly, Fnatic don't really have the damage to take out everybody from Origin without getting blown up first.
No, it's very true. But we did talk in the beginning of the game that they do have a lot of serious late game damage. The issue is, it's still taking a long time getting there, and they are running out of options fast.
Yeah, there has to be a lot of poke damage from Febiven and Reckless before any fight for this actually to work for Fnatic here. And that's, you know, unfortunate because the team were looking to have a strong end to the split after IEM.
And even if Fnatic were to get any of that poke down or get in an advantageous position, Mithy just has the fight reset button in Tempered Fate. He's hit multi-man targets. Even if it doesn't find somebody on Fnatic, just the split that would be required would buy Origin time. 10 seconds left on Baron buff in that top lane. 3,000 gold more than Fnatic is what Origin have earned.
TB from Gamsu. This is the last ditch
the top
play.
Lane. The last ditch play indeed. The Q finds amazing, as does the True Shot Barrage, but the Fisher does nothing.
Well, they landed a lot of poke. Let's see if they can get the kill. They managed to find themselves one. It's amazing going down. Febiven will get the kill secure for that one. Fnatic, though, clumping up, trying to turtle it all in, and a lot of damage dealt on both sides as Mithy picks up Klai. Some portal combat coming in, and now it's 4-on-4. Let's see if Fnatic can hold the line.
Good
here,
block.
Going way too low. Excellent block from Gamsu, but it's not enough. Beckett coming in, trying to evaporate the double kill. That's going, and he's going oh so low. Gamsu, Reckless, shut down. Reckless gets the secure on that one, but Origin are still too many members. Gamsu holding the line. The death timers, they're too high.
The Winions have already taken down a Nexus turret, and Origin, Ace, Fnatic, destroy the base and finish the spring split in fourth place.
What a difference having Peke as the starter can make. Even if it's all in their heads, doesn't mean it's not real.
One, two, three, Origin!
Ecstatic faces from Origin. Truthfully, it was 35 minutes of control. A slow buildup to a dramatic crescendo. And there was no doubt that Origin were the better team today.
No doubt at all, looking at it, the way the game evolved. The early ganks onto Peke put Febiven behind. Mithy got himself involved in 14 out of 15 kills on this bar. He was everywhere around the map, but it was enough. Sven, Peke, hand in hand, having enough damage to take out Fnatic. Fnatic didn't seem to have any answers to it.
No, they were trying to stall, but when you fall back and retreat constantly, eventually, you back out over a cliff, and they just fell down. No damage at the end of it. I mean, they tried to hold on. Reckless was pulling miracle plays, but it just wasn't enough. And Fnatic have, I think they have some soul searching to do, regardless of how the playoffs turn out for them.
0-2 this week, dropping games to Elements and to Origin. Teams who coming into the week We're in the battle for 7th and for 6th. Admittedly, it was 4th through 6th, but it's more dramatic if I say it that way.
There you go.
But we're getting much...
All stories deserve a bit of embellishment.
I know. Getting closer to defining that battle, because, of course, there's a maximum number of tiebreakers of 2 now. Yep. Origin, 4th. They take the highest possible seed in that 3-horse race.
Yeah, and that we really wouldn't have thought that. Going maybe 3, just right before IEM, you would have thought, well, wait a minute, Origin are going to be 4th place and then Unicorn's going to be right behind them. No, that's not even going to happen. It's actually really, really crazy how things have kind of shifted in the last couple of weeks when everyone scrambles to try and get it all together. But Origin have emerged, not just in this game, looking as a cleaner team, a better team. And that momentum, it means so much going into postseason.
Way more confidence out of Origin than we've seen, really, in any of their performances. And, you know, we discussed earlier in the pregame to this, what would be some of the factors here? We were talking about how, you know, the top lane, if Soaz can get himself a matchup against Gamsu that is somewhat favorable to him, like, that should be able to upset it. And Soaz played with the same confidence that, you know, when he's on form, he actually can play with.
First rotation, Poppy and Corki for Fnatic. Gamsu looked okay. He looked comfortable. He may have used Keeper's Verdict a few too many times early, which allowed him to get dived, allowed Origin some wiggle room when those skirmishes broke out. But I'm a lot more surprised by Febivant and that Corki. The lane swap and the very slow tempo of how they get Febivant into games, it was like going back to IEM where Fnatic just showed a level of misunderstanding or not understanding how to play around that Corki.
I think the thing, though, about that was Febivant had to respect the Trundle that early. Like, if you don't at least exhaust, like, he's going to kill you. And then from there, he had to play on the back foot because then the flash came out as well. So he gave it the respect that it was required at that point and then farmed up, but just couldn't really put the damage out.
It also has to be said, this game, the early game, there was a number of ganks onto Febby.
Oh, yeah.
You know, flash and exhaust blown very early. Like, there was pressure to keep him down. So
that
you have
true,
to take that into account.
But Spirit picks Lee Sin and has no early game impact. You cannot afford to let that happen. And Fnatic, they've got some answers to search for, but we'll have to see what the analyst desk thinks. I personally want to see what Krepo says about that. Bard, take it away, guys.
He's not here.
We kicked him off.
But we have some better things, maybe. Xpeke and Soaz. Yeah, first off, congratulations. 4th place lock-in. In all honesty, is that a lot better than you had thought it would be coming into the week?
Yeah, kind of. I was expecting maybe 5th place or something like this. And I thought, I mean, I didn't know how it was going to be, but I knew when they said they wanted me to play because of the champs I play, I was like, shit, we're going to lose against Fnatic now.
Is that how it went? Did the team say that they want to play with you?
Yeah, they just decide based on picks and who fits better against every team pretty much. And they were like, on blue side, it's probably better to play with him because we are going to blind pick mid anyway. So they ended up picking Corki, so it didn't matter.
Yeah, in the end.
I mean, it should matter in-game, though, because you actually had a very good performance. Mm. Same for the man in the top lane with Trundle. Did you guys expect the IEM picks coming in for Fnatic and then just had the Trundle ready and also the Poppy that Gamsu's been playing like 4 games in a row almost now?
We actually expected the Poppy, like, if they would blind pick something, it would be Poppy, right? Mm-hmm. So we kind of knew about it. We were thinking they could maybe go Rammus or Trundle, maybe. It's possible, right? But we thought that if they would blind pick something, they would go for the Poppy. So, yeah, we knew.
Do you feel overall Fnatic has a very predictable pick and ban phase?
Well, for top lane, kind of, because you don't like play so much, and they often play the same thing in solo queue that they would play the same week in LCS. So it's funny, but yeah,
okay.
A bit not too much, but certain positions, yes.
As for the game plan, Peke, we saw a lot of focus on your lane. You had a gank from Bard. You had an AD carry gank, the infamous AD carry gank. You had a gank from Trundle. What was up with that?
I didn't want to feed, you know? Gank my lane or get kicked. That's how it went.
If you show, you wanted to look at a couple of replays involving
Yeah, I mean, we had something with your Soaz, just overall with Gamsu as well. So top lane stuff in a lane swap. First thing we see is Soaz is greedy, going to be a little bit greedy for waves, and he's going to push out the top lane here. Do you remember the situation? Reckless and Klai shows up top lane. The wave is going to push against you. So Fnatic actually decides after pushing you off the wave to then recall with the AD carry and support and run them all the way down to the bottom lane. And you can see Gams on your minimap coming to top lane here. This play specifically, what do you think about that?
So basically it's like as soon as they chunk me and I see them not hitting the wave, I knew that the top lane will come and get the bounce. But in the same time, as you can see on the minimap, their bot lane is missing a lot of farm at the turret. So they're basically trading their AD farm for their top lane freeze. But it's not like I'm missing so much. Like I miss maybe one wave, and then I went to top lane and we got the Poppy flash with a gank from Bard, and I still like didn't get the freeze. So I missed one wave for their bot lane missing like maybe two. So it's basically a trade that they're doing.
Yeah, and it's also very interesting with Fnatic later on in the game. They keep putting Gamzu in side lanes where he's not able to freeze the waves. So like he's slightly behind us as a top laner. And whenever there's a wave pushing out, they keep putting Gamzu in that lane. And you actually went down and killed him at some point.
The thing is, at first they tried to put him on bot to freeze the lane. But I could just, we took me turret because of that.
Right.
Because I push him, I go mid, I push him, I go mid. And at some point Swaz move as well and we take turret. So then he realized it was not working, so he tried to push the wave. But then he died because he's like with full armor. I think he had some fire and one more armor item or something. So I just one-shot him almost.
But is this on the team then? Because what normally you would see was you would put AD carry, support jungle to push out the waves and then get the deep vision in the jungle. They're pushing out like you guys were doing over and over and over. So you have always a deep vision. Do you think this is a team call? Do you think maybe it's Gamzu saying, you know, I have to take this wave here? Or do you have any idea like what's going on?
I just think they didn't have so much pressure. Like, Corki never went to side lane until he had package at level 13 or something. And Poppy cannot win against Trundle early on. And at some point, PK was beating her as well because he was 2 level up with like a lot of items because we helped him a lot early on. So both of their heroes couldn't really go side lane, so they didn't have much pressure and probably didn't get the deep vision. But
yeah,
they can still force it, but they just like didn't do it really.
And it just meant you guys could do almost whatever you wanted on the map, over and over.
Yeah, and end up winning the game. Let's take a look at the bracket, the playoff bracket, because it's filled in. Because of this, you actually push Fnatic to the 6th place because of the head-to-head versus UOL. There it is. Oh, and there it was.
There it is.
That was so a really beautiful bracket,
what do you think?
Yeah.
What do you think? This is the playoff bracket right here.
Good. Now, I'm sure it'll come up again in 1 second. Okay. There we go. Obviously, Fnatic now ends up playing Vitality, and you guys end up playing the Unicorns of Love. What do you think of that matchup as your first one in the playoffs?
Nice. Yeah.
A little more?
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm obviously happy I play against Unicorns. I don't know. They seem to be really strong against other teams. They always give problems to all the top teams, but against us, it seems like they played really, really bad both times. Like the time that Tristan was playing, they did really bad draft, and against us as well, they were like a bit, even though they started the game well, they were a bit clueless on how to play the map really good, so I prefer to face them instead of Fnatic or someone else.
Do you guys think maybe Unicorns, so you said you prefer to play them over Fnatic. Is this something where you guys just know exactly how they play? Or like, why are they playing so bad? There must be a specific reason, like you guys maybe figured them out and you just don't know it yet?
Maybe it's that, because it was both times against us that they seem to not play as good as against other teams. Like when you see them playing against other teams, they seem to do smart things, have a good idea against us. It's just like they are playing, we can know what they're gonna do. It's really weird, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, we'll see in the playoffs. I'd wanna ask you who you think is gonna play in the mid lane for most of those games, but I don't think I'm gonna get a straight up answer.
I don't even know myself.
You don't even know yourself.
I don't think anyone knows.
So as
we're gonna decide later, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah. What are your feelings so as now with, of course, yesterday you had a great performance as well with Power. You were doing well, seemed to be in a good place. Playoff thoughts, playoff so as enabled.
He was
He was feeding.
We'll see about that.
Okay. We will see about that. Well, in any case, congratulations. Fantastic 4th place for you guys.
Thank you.
All right. Well, it's time for a quick break, but when we return, we'll look towards the fight at the bottom of the standings between Giants and Rocket. Stay tuned.
If Source would actually play well.
Yes, imagine that.
They memed about Source. Source, after he gave the death away yesterday, they were like, okay, so please, Source has the only death. LOL, guys.
Big package on in there, and Exhaust is down, instantaneously stunned up. Origin looking for a second win. Everyone's getting bloody, and the first one goes to Amazing.
Becca getting the assist on that one. Spirit gets picked off to Sven, and he's down. Reckless with a pickup to answer it back. One. Reckless trying to kite out, but Pekka is hunting. He's going. Chains are on. He takes him out for Reckless. That was too much for a pass for him. Febivin now going low. Stopped by the pillar. Taken down. It's only Clyde.
And Origin, Ace, Fnatic, destroy the base and finish the spring split in 4th place.